So factor led to the success of the program was, I think, the team is playing to win. We had no choice, all right? If we were first to market, we would have not done any of this stuff, all right? Because we would have held on to that great cholesterol-lowering capability. The other brands were playing, well, we're not gonna lose. And what they did was, they brought them off strategy. So they didn't want to go against head-to-head Lipitor. So let's talk about things that nobody knew about. HDL, high-density lipid protein, the good cholesterol. The other drugs start talking about, well, we raise HDL more. Well, they did, but nobody really knew what that meant. They talked about something called C-reactive protein, which was a marker of inflammation, that they lowered that marker of inflammation. We did too, but we didn't want to talk about it because it wasn't a strategy. Then, of course, their statins, their drugs, were more like natural ones. And we were synthetic. So natural things, of course, are naturally good for you. Right? Like ricin is the most toxic compound in the world, and it's natural. But anyhow, natural substances, they did this. They got off strategy and it killed them. Right? Because they weren't sticking to their message. So eventually they decided to play to win, and they lost. Now, the article that I have under here, which I'll just skip over, was a trial called the Prove It Trial, in which Bristol-Myers Squibb decided, all right, we're going to do a head-to-head study against Lipitor. And they designed a study that was underpowered so that the results at the end would be neutral. And we were like, how could Squibb be neutral? They ran the study, and they lost their own study. And they tried to come back in, it was too late. They lost their franchise when they did that. And you think about today, today's economy, what companies now are suffering from playing to win or just trying to keep their space, not to lose? All right, we'll see how it comes out. Most incredible factor was that a lot of the stuff succeeded. You should never expect the majority of innovation portfolio to succeed. There should be a heck of a lot of failure. But we were very fortunate that we were able to have a drug that was beneficial as it was, and endpoints, surrogate endpoints, that really worked. You see jumping up and down with our results back, because we didn't know what was going to happen.